Thor Heyerdahl is one of the 20th century's biggest ethnographers. He's known for his Kon-Tiki expedition and work on the Polynesians. Probably the biggest what the fuck theory that he ever created was the one where he theorized that the Vikings originated from what is now Azerbaijan. His evidence? Just a bunch of petroglyphs in the Gobustan region of Azerbaijan that contain illustrations of longships that look really similar to the ones that the Vikings used that are around 5,000 to 8,000 years old, and absolutely nothing else. Never mind the fact that that part of the Caucasus wasn't even called Azerbaijan until the 20th century. Never mind the fact that his theory for how the Vikings wound up in Scandinavia is that they migrated there from that part of the Southern Caucasus through waterways, when anyone who can find Azerbaijan on the map can see that the Caspian Sea doesn't end anywhere near Northern Europe, and that the Black Sea region, where we know they were active in, is located in the complete opposite direction where Georgia is. Never mind the fact that we know when the Viking Age began in Scandinavia. It started towards the end of the 8th century AD and subsisted until the mid-11th century AD. So where did the Vikings get their time machine and teleportation machine? Because if their pagan science and technology that Varg wets his pants over never created a time machine and a teleportation machine to get to Scandinavia through a manufactured waterway that got suppressed and destroyed by the Middle Eastern death cult of Christianity, then Heyerdahl was wrong, and his scholarship should be thrown into the trash heap of history. Moreover, a cursory look at the genetic samples sequenced between the populations of Scandinavia and Azerbaijan clearly show that the Vikings are about as related to the latter as they are to the Surinamese. I guess their phenotypes and genotypes changed over time due to the weather. Heck, anthropologists don't even accept his scholarship about the Polynesians either. 20th century Nordic ethnographers? Least reliable source on historical information ever. They think that bullshit coincidences such as this site in a completely unrelated and irrelevant geographic locale is solid evidence. Even people from Equatorial Guinea can tell that this is a coincidence. Only universities like Cambridge and Oxford are reliable. By the way, you should read their books sometime. The UK is the greatest country in Europe right now for a reason. And this is where I end my dissertation. Thank you for watching.